Radio check, Platinum 3.
Landing Charlie on me.
11:30. He was up in the air. Are you getting any bad friends? I'm getting really choppy.
Yeah, I am actually. Well, a little bit of chop here and there, but I think it'll clean itself off.
Yeah, I hope so.
Hey, go to your link 16 page real quick.
Say again?
I say go to your link 16 page real quick.
You say link 16 page?
Yeah, your data link on DED.
Yeah, I'm on there.
Okay, go to your second page. Or sorry, your third page, P3.
Do what on the second page, sorry?
No, go to the third page, where it shows all the stations.
Okay, third page.
Alright, read me your top two stations.
17643. 0 Alpha 647. Oh wait, 0 Alpha 647 is for number 5. So for number 1, it's 17643.
And what's your number 2 right below it?
Number 2 is 0 Alpha 644.
Okay, so my stations on mine are 02154, and then number 2 is 02155.
That's interesting.
I don't think you're showing up on my D-Link. When you go to page 2, does it show UI for Uzi, RU22?
Checking. I am Uzi22. Or UI22.
Okay. Your flight lead is checked off as no.
Affirm.
Alright, we'll see. Maybe it'll be correct in the air.
So you said channel 1, 02154, channel 2, 02155.
Yeah, that's what my first two channels are.
I just updated mine, see if that works.
Oh, well, I was going to say don't mess with it. I was going to see what happens.
Oh.
I mean, you got time if you want to reslot one more time.
I mean, I guess I can do that.
Check to make sure I picked the right slot. Yeah, slot flight two.
Okay, I'm gonna. That actually probably is a good
Cross
idea.
Cross traffic, code one, three ship F-16, taxi runway 17 right.
So I'm gonna restart restart the game and hop back in.
That's fine. We got time.
Okay.
Data tape loaded.
Boston traffic, code 1 is departing runway 17 right, heading north. Boston traffic, code 1, departing your airspace to the north, last call, Boston traffic.
Hey Mouse, your guys' data link working?
Affirmative.
Alright. I was just asking because our stations were off on ours. I don't know why. So hopefully when he reslots, that'll be corrected.
Cap. There's a two ship over the target.
Well, maybe we'll get lucky then and only have to fight a two ship.
We're gonna be on button 16, right?
You wanna use that or you wanna use Dark Star since we're farther west?
Alright, we'll use button 15.
Alright.
Three satellite.
Frame rates are a lot better.
Yeah, you're actually showing up blue now for me on the HSD.
No. Yeah, I'm not sure what happened there.
That's alright. When you're done aligning, I just want to recheck the page again and see if they're both off again or if they're actually aligned.
Yep, we'll do. So channel 1 shows 17643, channel 2 shows 0 alpha 644.
Okay, I don't understand why they're so different, but whatever, as long as it works, I guess.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking too.
Alright, when you're done aligning and everything, we're gonna go arm the jet here as well.
Copy, I still need to change my skin real quick.
Go ahead and take two Bravos on 1 and 9, and then we're going to take 9 X's on 2 and 8.
Copy, two Bravos on 1 and 9, two Charlies on 2 and 8. Two's up and ready, by the way.
Copy, I'm loading right now. Looks like we don't have any V1s, so we're just going to take the V3 penetrators.
Copy, so we just rearm here?
Yep. No head, no centerline.
Confirm no head.
Yeah, we don't need it for what we're doing.
Two has a good jet. Impact velocity set to 500.
Check your sticks. Whatever. I don't care. Like I said, we're doing two 9Xs and two Bravos, but you got a bunch of Charlies.
Oh, you said two 9Xs and two Bravos?
Yeah.
Copy, I'll update them. Not sure why, I could have swore I heard two Bravos, two Charlies, but my brain doesn't work lately, so...
That's alright.
Swapping them out now. Two swapped out, ready to go.
Vassal traffic, Colt 1, fly 2 Vipers, taxiing to runway 17 right. Alright, flight, release parking brake, pedo heat on, arm the seat, lights to steady, nose wheel staying engaged, one's roll.
Two good, jet ready to roll.
I'll have to put your lights to steady. Pass all traffic. Colt 1, Flight 2 Vipers, departing runway 17 right to the south. Taxi light on. Do 4 second spacing.
Copy 4 second spacing.
Sorry, not taxi light, landing light. Brakes on, run up. And lead rolling.
Two rolling.
Knees up and clean, come out of the lower.
Two up, wheels up.
Coming right.
Two.
Maintain about 4 degree, 3 to 4 degree climb.
Two.
Vassal traffic, Colt 1, Flight of Vipers, departing airspace to the west. Last call, vassal traffic. Flight first price 6. Center, Colt 1, Flight 2 Vipers, departing Vassal, Angels 2, for Angels 2-2. And flight rejoin, echelon right when able.
2 copy, almost settled. I'm flying with a butt kicker now, so it's really weird. This is the first time I've ever done it.
Do you like it so far?
So far, it's super realistic.
I really want something like that. Is it like actually attached to your seat, or do you sit on it?
Yeah, I ended up getting the butt kicker too advanced. I had to get a special mount because of my secret lab, and then I ended up getting a nice amp for it. It's pretty good.
Right on. Rolling out for steer point 2.
Two. It's really cool because when you hit the burners, it stops vibrating. Like it vibrates a lot more when you're not in burner.
Interesting.
Yeah, I'm not sure what the logic is. I wonder if that's a glitch. I forgot when I'm changing options, I can't control the jet. I had to turn up the volume a little bit. It was too quiet. I couldn't hear stuff, like, in the jet. I don't care what people say, our Vipers are the prettiest.
What, the Colorado ones?
No, I just mean Vipers in general.
Yeah, that's a good looking jet. I can't argue with that. I've just always had a thing for the Aardvark. It's just something about that jet and how fast it is.
You say the Aardvark?
Yeah, it's the F-111.
Yeah, that is a pretty cool jet. That's definitely cool. F-22 is my bird of choice.
I was actually just listening to the Firepipe podcasts on that episode today.
Yeah, maybe one day we'll get to fly them virtually, huh?
Well, you know, you can use the mod for the time being.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's something they'll ever release. Because of all the statistics behind it being so classified.
Oh yeah, that thing's probably never going to get declassified too. We'll be old by the time it does.
We're flying space jets by then.
Yeah.
Nose coming down level now. Center Colt 1 checking out of Pry 6, going Pry 15 for Dark Star. Push Pry 15. Dark Star Colt 1, Fly 2 Viper is with you. Bulls 129er for 09er. Remington Colt.
You mean Colt Remington?
That's fine. All right, we'll be Remington then. Anyways, just skip tanker. You just gotta go ahead and push.
Yeah, we are. We already pushed, but we're getting pinged by the. We got a mud spike by the ships.
Is there still a ship there? I thought the Navy took care of it.
Negative, defending.
God damn it.
Famous last words, thought the Navy took care of it. It was the same last time we flew. We thought the Navy took care of something and they didn't.
Yeah, there's still ships here.
Alright. What do you want? What do you want to do? You want to try to weasel the boat out of missiles? I mean, that's a lot of damn missiles, but...
Would they have like what, 16 or 24?
I don't want to know.
Yeah, we just defended some missiles coming out, so we're heading to Alamo right now. We gotta regroup, figure this out.
Copy. I mean, I think we got a lot of terrain over here because it's at like northern, that western northern portion of Turkey. So I mean, if we want to maybe just use the terrain, we'll refuel.
Copy. We were going to try to fire on the SA-2 if it showed up, and then refuel and then cap for you all.
Oh, Art, just let me know what you want. We're just coming up on the refueling steer point right now.
Copy. We're regrouping at Alamo.
There's Arco 3 off the 2 o'clock.
To copy, but blind on him. Two visual. You got him locked, right?
Yeah, I do.
Man, I love the way data link works now.
Yeah, right.
Not perfect, but a lot better than it was a year ago.
Coming right.
Two.
Colt, we're going to hit the tanker. We'll hang out there and listen in. Let me know what you want to do.
Gabby, we're coming up with a plan now.
Darkstar Remington, checking out Pry 15, going Pry 19 for Arco 3. Fly, push Pry 19. Echo 3, Remington 1, Flight 2 Vipers inbound for rejoin, low state 10.6. Hold on out. And now coming left.
Two.
Ascending for rejoin and slow down.
He's not paying attention.
You're good.
looking for my button to turn my radar off.
Yeah, go ahead and ports open, nose cold.
Let's switch to echelon left, or are we in a quick flow?
No, we're in a quick flow.
Man, this chair rumble kind of freaks me out every once in a while.
Wow, that was a quick turn. Okay then. Try one more time. Need an answer?
I didn't hear you on frequency. That was me.
Arco 3, Colt 1, 3 ship F-16 inbound for rejoin. About 20 miles to your west. Low state is 7.4.
Remington 1-2 moving for contact.
Remington 1, Colt 1. So we can go low level and try to take out the SA-2, but then how are you all going to drop the bombs on the runway?
We could probably trade mask and loft them in there.
You want to take that risk? Because we can do it.
Let's grab gas, and then the Alamo point looks like it's pretty feet dry, and then we'll take a look at the terrain and stuff and make a call from there.
Copy that.
Maybe my two and I will roll in low, use a hill we can find, pop up, get one JDOM off a piece on different portions of the field, and then take off back east.
Copy that.
If we would have known that ship was still there, I would have just had us brought 38s and slaying them at like 19, 20 miles away from the airfield.
I don't think you can get that close to the airfield with that ship there.
Yeah, I guess we'll see. How many times did shoot at you guys?
I got one missile after me. And two got one missile on him.
All right, two, go ahead and slot in. Echelon right again, coming off left.
Two.
Breaking power up. Alright, we'll get back up to point 8 and then we'll climb a little bit.
Two. So is that ship off to the west of our target? Is that what they're talking about?
Yeah, I think it's still right next to that airstrip. Climbing up to Angels 2-3. Hopefully that's just right at the bottom of this top layer, but we'll see. Push 3.6. Alright, bring the power back for you. Let's try to go max fuel conserve. Arco 3, Remington 1, checking out of your airspace. It's probably 15. And flight fence in.
Say again, last?
Fence in.
Two fenced in, fuel state 11.5.
All right, so I got a Mike Romeo, which is a 52 Bravo. Off of the 11. Or it's a 54 Alpha. So it could be either one.
How are you seeing that?
So I'm looking at my ALEC table, the codes there, and then matching it up with the RWR symbol.
Copy, I don't have anything on the RDBR.
Interesting. On 60, that's way south.
Okay, I see it now. About 11 o'clock, supposedly a Type 02. Or 052 Bravo destroyer.
Yeah, it's either that or the 54 Alpha frigate.
Copy that.
And yard six up, 56. No, hold on. 6123. There we go.
Copy, yard six up.
I'm just probing to see if we can even get close enough to see the airfield and the targeting pod.
Two copy.
quite a bit of terrain over here, from what I'm seeing. We might be able to get away with it.
You think you can drop them and duck behind the terrain?
Yeah. I don't know if we're gonna be able to ingress quick enough without being shot at. Now I got HN and MR. What's HN? HN is a 52 Charlie destroyer.
Copy, I got only Mike Romeo.
Try the TGT step. Oh joy, two Mike Romeos, Hotel November. So we got two hostiles, Angels 26.
Copy, tracking hostiles, 11 o'clock, Angels 26. Just behind strip point 7.
If we get locked by the boat, just split S and head back to strip point 6, which is Alamo. I got another Hotel November that's in the inner ring.
Two, same.
About 50 miles out, looking at a mountain still. Coming off.
Two spike.
Flow north. And 360.
Who's off here, 4 o'clock, Lou?
Visual. All right, let's head back to Alamo, steer point 6.
Two.
Dark Star, Colt 1 checking back in, 3 ship F-16, just left Arco 3.
So we're able to get within 40 miles, but I can't get a picture of the field. I think it's behind the mountain.
Copy. You got bandits on your 6.
Copy. We're flying to Alamo right now.
Copy. We're heading to Alamo. Flanking you now.
Copy. Yeah, I keep getting the calls for Darkstar with bandits that are all the way in the south. I wonder if we should switch to Overlord.
We got calls from 270.
I see I'm getting 216 for 170 miles.
Yeah, that's the one from the west. They just popped up. They're at Angels 28.
Alright.
We're about 12 miles away. I mean, 12 minutes.
Copy. Looks like they're not interested. Bring the power back.
So the ship fired, did you have 40?
No, he was spiking us at 40. I didn't want to press it because we're a bit heavy.
Copy.
There is a lot of high terrain over here though.
So our plan is we're going to come down at Alamo. And we will drop down to terrain mask and then try to see if we can lock up the two and fire.
Copy. Yeah, it looks like some of the peaks in this area, like the highest peak is 7.6.
Copy.
Let's go ahead and form up a 1 mile trail and we'll hold in a right hand orbit here.
Thank you.
Well, any ideas?
Well, I mean, the idea of them coming in low, that might work. I was gonna say, what if we tried something like that?
Yeah.
Thing is, lofting a JDAM, you think that'll work?
I was looking at some of the area over there. There's a lake to the northeast. That's about 33 miles from the field.
32 miles?
Yeah, 32, 33 miles-ish.
I don't think that's going to be close enough, is it?
Oh, no, definitely not. Not for these 31s. These 31s, even at 500 knots minimum, we can only probably launch them at max 8 to 10 miles. And that's at 22,000 feet. I don't know how close we need to be when we're low.
Yeah, fair enough. We can try and empty out the boat.
That's the only other solution I can come up with. Yeah, I'm gonna be heads down, writing down some coordinates from the F10 map.
So the SA-2 is the only threat we know that's there that could hit us if we come in low, right?
Oh, no, no, no. There's like 15s and 19s there as well.
Colt 1 is dropping down to 8,000. We are crossing Alamo, heading to the target.
So they're gambling really heavily.
Well, what they're trying to do is just get the 2 to come on and then probably take a pre-briefed or EOM shot at it.
So part of me thinks the smart decision is to just head home because we were never prepared to handle that boat.
No, I agree. I just want to take a look, see at some things. Okay, so there's two lakes on the map in that area. I have them set as 11 and 12 for me. I just want to take a look at them.
Code 1 is about 60 miles away from the target.
Hold out.
If we got low, they're going to man-pad us, aren't they?
I think if we only fly over the airfield, I don't think there's anything else all the way out here. Alright, I'm heading towards my steer point 11 that I made. Let's drop down below this cloud layer. Go 5 degrees down.
And 2.
Bring the power back quite a bit, just kind of cruising. What would be nice if it was modeled is if our harms would damage the radar on the ship.
Yeah, we could really use that right now.
Yeah, like module damage. Colt 1 Remington.
Go for Colt 1. There's a bandit.
Okay, as long as you saw him, I'm watching him as well.
Hey, Remington, can you fire on them? Because we're hooking.
Too far for us, can't get a lock. They're about 70 miles out from us.
Copy.
I mean, I guess we can try and bait him out, but it doesn't look like... Oh no, that might actually work.
Yeah, coming right.
Two.
Remington, I think we lost our number two.
I still see him on the HSD. Not seeing him visually, though. We're about Angels 14.
We lost contact with him. We're heading back to Alamo.
Yep, we're following you up. Looks like those bandits are dropping down to Angels 13.
Landing?
I don't know what they're doing. I'm at a 4-degree climb.
Two has visual, just trailing you about 2 miles out.
Copy. We'll head 090.
Two.
Those dudes were coming in hot. I don't know what they're doing now.
Looks like they're turning. Well, one looks like it's still hot.
Colt, we're going to switch to Overlord, see if this is better, because he's calling out dudes that are 140 miles away.
Copy, we'll switch over also.
Darkstar checking out, push him probably 16.
Overlord, Colt 1, 3 ship F-16, checking in. Angels 2-2, 2-3.
Okay.
I'll smoke what he's smoking.
That's what I'm saying.
Alright, what do you think we should do?
Honestly, I don't think we're equipped to deal with any of this. We can't. What are we gonna do against a boat that's gonna shoot us from like 60 miles away?
So all three of those bandits are gone now.
Yeah, off the data link. You know they're still there though.
Copy that. So you RTB?
Yeah, I might as well just call it military and RTB.
Copy. Colt 1, RTB.
We're gonna come on RTB. Alright, 2, go ahead and join back up.
2, say again?
Let's just go ahead and join back up. Like you said, we're pretty much ill-equipped to deal with this.
2.
And to steer point 7.
2.
There's a lot of good terrain over there. I don't know. I don't want to risk it.
Copy that.
Southern Turkey aerial tours brought to you by the state.
Yeah, I mean, what are we going to bring against that boat?
On the bright side, we found the boat before it killed us, so at least the bad intel didn't end up landing us, you know, dead.
True.
Two saddle right.
Visual. He's watching Arco 3 in the pod.
So did you see the F-35 real sim throttle came out today?
No, I did not.
Yeah, so they released it for pre-order. It's $2,000, and until they sell 200 of them, they won't make them.
Excuse me?
Yeah, so they're 2,000 bucks a pop. They said that in $200 batches, or sorry, 200 count batches, they're only $2,000. After that, they're going to be almost $4,000 to make in small quantities. And so what they're saying is, until, like, they have until the end of January, I think, is their timer thing. But it's going to be like a Kickstarter. So unless it hits 100% funded for 200 of them, they're going to give everyone their money back and not make it.
That's crazy.
It's crazy for price, yeah. And the fact that they're saying that it's super cheap, like, they said that to make small manufacturing runs, it's going to cost like double. And then they said if a bunch of people pre-order and the price goes down, that they'll actually give people money back.
Interesting.
But yeah, they have a little progress bar on their website, so it's just like a little Kickstarter where you can see the progress.
Did you put in for it? Are you getting one?
I figured, yeah. I mean, I figured worst case, I get my money back, and best case, I'll end up getting a throttle that they won't even be selling for that cheap anymore, so I could resell it if I don't like it. And Loco got one.
Oh, okay. Pushing steer point 8.
2.
And coming right.
2.
White, go ahead and fence out.
And 2 fenced out, fuel state 7.7.
Copy.
So yeah, between me and Loco, they're 1% to goal.
If you end up getting it, are you going to get rid of your current throttle?
I don't know. See, like, there's stuff I like about this Windwing, and then there's stuff I like about that F-35 one. I'm really hoping that they'll create an F-16 grip for it, which they keep saying they will. So I might hold on to the Windwing for a couple of months and then see which one I like more. Like, I'm not the world's biggest fan on a sliding throttle. I kind of like the radius a little bit, but yeah.
I don't know, couldn't tell you. Overlord Remington 1, checking out price 16, going price 6. Price 6. Center Remington 1, play 2 Vipers with you. Bulls 318 for 6-6.
Center Colt 1, 3 ship F-16, checking in, Angels 2-3, heading back to Boston.
What are you seeing for bullseye?
315 for 47.
That is interesting. I'm seeing 335 for 88.
On your HSD, is it to the south of steer point 8 right now?
Don't. No, it's steer point 8. Yeah, I'm on steer point 8. I should take a screenshot. I shit you not, I'm seeing three different values. Seeing 334 for 100, 336 for 83, and 334 for 99 on the three different indicators.
Wow, that's an accomplishment.
Two of them synced up now. So just curious, where do you see bullseye right now? I see it about, from where we're sitting, about 1 o'clock off of steer point 8, about 35, 40 miles.
Yeah. That's what I see. So mine is 310 for 28.
That's weird. Okay, well, I'm not gonna sweat it.
Alright, since this is all water ahead of us, let's go 5 degrees down.
I just realized it's been a really long time since I've landed heavy.
Shouldn't be too bad. We're on internal right now.
Yeah, it's not super bad, I suppose.
That's why I'm going low. Burn up a little more fuel by the time we get there.
Gotta admire the beauty of this game.
Yeah, I'm glad we just went on a tour today.
Yeah, we saw some nice clouds.
Sign around me, come on, checking out price 6-1 par 1 for Brazil. Just par 1. Brazil traffic, Remington 1, flight to Vipers, inbound for runway 35 left for a left overhead break.
Boston traffic, Colt 1 is having communication issues. We are on a 10-mile final for a straight in on 17 right.
Coming right to 160.
Two. You know, when we were coming through the cloud, it was so easy. Like, I can totally see how people can get spatially disoriented. It's crazy.
Fossil traffic, 1 mile final for runway 17, right, full stop.
Like, all of a sudden it got dark and it almost looked like a clear sky. Like, am I going straight up? Trust the instruments, right?
Yep. All right, bring it back idle and coming left for a runway lineup.
Two.
Boston traffic, Colt 1, clear of 17 right on taxiway belt.
Fossil traffic, Remington 1 flight of 2 Vipers, initial runway 35 left. Left overhead break. Fossil traffic. Hamilton 1-1 in the break.
Boston traffic, Colt 1 is back taxiing on 17 left.
Boston traffic, Remington 1, 3 down the lock for runway 35 left, full stop. One's a little wide right, but that's alright.
I had the same problem. It just didn't pull.
Yeah, it came down a little hard. I don't really care. One on the left.
Boston traffic, Remington, Colt 1, clear runway 17 left.
Fossil traffic, Remington on flight, clear 35 left.
Fossil traffic, boat 1 is crossing 17 right.
Seriously, like those last few knots, like it just didn't want to stop.
All that weight. Alright, I'm parking the one to my left and the armored jet.
Traffic. Colt 1, clear back to runway 17 right.
Alright, shutting her down.